And that was new stuff from Flying Colors off their terrific new album, You Never Know. That was Do You Feel the Same? Just released a couple weeks ago on Poison City Records. And now we are into the good stuff. We got Orbit 17 in the studio. Jamie, Misha, and Cliff. We're going to do jam band style. There's a set list, but we have no idea how it's going to unfold, which just makes it all the better. I'm really excited to have you guys in the studio. If you, for those of you at home, on the road, at a show, I really love the idea of somebody being at a show, listening to this show. there's a set break somewhere. There's between bands. They're described, self-described, as Imagine Flaming Lips meets Tame Impala in outer space with one thousandth the budget. Give or take. That is straight from what we were provided from them.
That sounds like the kind of thing I would say.
Yeah, it sure does. So welcome to the studio. Welcome to KXSF. Thank you for coming by on this Wednesday night and coming all the way up here to San Francisco. It's great to have you guys.
Yeah, thank you so much for having us. It's great to be here. Very exciting.
Yeah, I like the mood lighting we've gotten here. Thanks to Scott for helping us keep everything going and sounds on and everything at all times. Why don't you guys introduce a song and get us started?
Okay, sure. Should we just go straight into a song then? All right, well, this first song is called Big Sur. It's a song, if I were going to be glib, I'd say it's a song about camping. Really, it's kind of a song about being out in the wilderness with someone that you have a relationship with and kind of being isolated off on your own together.
Beautiful. I love
that. Yeah. I guess without further ado,
here's Orbit 17.
Your eyes at
Right on, right on. That sounds exactly like what I think about when I'm going down Big Sur. That sounds exactly like going around all the bends, keeping your eye on the ocean and the cliffs and the road all at one time.
There you go.
Yeah, that was perfect. That was perfect. So you guys formed about a year ago, I understand.
That's about right. Yeah,
about a year ago.
We did our first show at the Caravan in July. July.
Yeah, and so I joined in May.
Yeah. Yeah, so you joined me, yeah. So, yeah, that's pretty much a year. Almost, not quite a year, but...
Yeah, it's great. We were... Jamie and I were working together for a bit, say approximately 4 or 6 months, just kind of getting the genesis of some of these songs mm-hmm. that would become the core of some of the material that we just released on Bonfires. And then, through kind of a lucky... circumstance, Cliff the drummer and I shared a rehearsal studio together, but had never really connected before I reached out to him about trying out for the band, and things just clicked immediately. And it's like, oh well, we're sharing a room, so this is, couldn't get any easier.
We have a pretty demanding list of things we need from our drummer here,
so yeah, he it worked out real well in that respect. And I say, yeah, about coming up on a year now.
Yeah.
So. Yeah, and you guys had released the EP Waves on Wires.
Yeah,
last year.
Yeah. Yeah. I forget when we did that, actually. It was October, maybe? October-ish? November, yeah.
Yeah, now we're coming out with the full LP out on April 28th.
That's right, yeah. It's been quite the journey.
Yeah. And so when you guys were recording, your songwriting process, is it mostly Jamie brings the ideas and then Cliff and Misha fill it out? How does that work for you guys?
Yeah, I mean, I guess, how would you describe it, actually?
Jamie does bring a lot to the table. And, beyond playing guitar and singing in the band in a live situation, she's also writing drum parts and bass parts and keyboard parts and backing vocal parts.
I kind of bring in a demo, I guess.
And yeah.
Yeah.
I would say it's pretty complete. We give some input. We make a few adjustments here and there, but... I think the core of the songwriting, Jamie's definitely kind of bringing us a mostly done thing. And then we just put a little bit of our, polish on it and our twist on it. And
I spend a lot of time
collaborate.
A lot of time in Logic on the DAW tool that you use for music composition.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so the 17 in Orbit 17, I've read, is based on the 17 years since you were last in a band.
You're gonna date myself now, but yeah, it's been... I mean, I've played music obviously since then in bands, but it's been that long since I was like the main, like this is gonna be my band and I'm gonna be the songwriter and these are my songs. And
absolutely. And what was it that got you to reform your leadership?
Really, when you boil it down, this is all kind of like a project to keep myself amused during like COVID lockdown that has completely spiraled out of control.
Yeah, and I'm thrilled to hear that somebody took a COVID musical sonic creation and went upbeat and grooving and melodic with it and not the sad, 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 sad.
I mean, it is... we have our moments, but...
Yeah, everybody does. I think that's being human, and if you're an artist, you have to have a sad. That's how you get half the population to pay attention, right?
Yeah.
Indeed, yes.
All right. Well, we're going to take a brief pause and thank some of the people that help keep the lights on here at KXSF, and we'll be right back with Orbit 17.
Hey, KXSF listeners and Bayview neighbors. Lucky Grocery Store is moving into the neighborhood with everything you love, all in one place. From local products to everyday items at prices you need. Check out the grand opening of your new Lucky store today at Bayview Plaza, the corner of 3rd Street and Evans. KXSF would like to thank Lucky Grocery Store for their support.
Let's not mince words. You've been loving what KXSF's been providing over the last few months. Relevant radio featuring not only music and artist interviews from the local scene, but also timely discussions with Bay Area activists and artists working to make our community a better place for all. And although KXSF is 100% volunteer staffed, we still need your help to stay on the air. If you can, please go online now to kxsf.fm and click on the donate button. Any amount, big or small, helps. Independent radio for the people, by the people. Thanks for supporting KXSF 102.5 FM, San Francisco.
Underwriting for KXSF comes from Noise, a record shop located in the Richmond District between 39th and 40th Avenue, specializing in local bands, artists, and music producers. Contact them calling 415-702-6006 or email them at noisemusicsf@gmail.com. Thanks to Noise for supporting San Francisco Community Radio KXSF.
And thank you all out there in Radio Land for keeping your Wednesday night tuned to KXSF 102.5 FM, San Francisco Community Radio. This is the King of Pressure Radio Show. I am DJ BK with you every Wednesday night from 8 to 10 p.m., bringing you the best of new music. If you're interested in being an underwriter, you can reach out to info@kxsf.fm. You'll get published on the your business's website on the cool kxsf.fm homepage. You can find out more at kxsf.fm/underwriting. And without further ado, we're going to hear more from Orbit 17. What do you guys got up next?
I think next we're going to play this song called Firefly. This is a song, it's kind of about like when you go home after being away for a long time and things have changed and there's this kind of weird feeling that, you know, you don't quite fit in the way you used to, or this is, you know, this feeling that you can't quite capture the past, essentially. I grew up in Louisiana. Fireflies is kind of like a thing that we had growing up, and you don't see them much anymore. And I don't know. I guess it's kind of about you can never really go back, I guess.
We're always going forward.
All right. So, yep.
How about it? This is Orbit 17 with Firefly.
Thank you.
Most excellent. Most excellent. That was great. So my next question for you guys, in the spirit of you can't go back, and since this project originated in the pandemic, what did you guys find yourselves listening to individually in the pandemic? Were you like a lot of people that just like went back to your old reliables? Did you go and just go like find the wonkiest stuff you could? Like, how did that go for you guys since this came from that?
Yeah, I mean, for me, honestly, I was listening to my own music probably way more than anything at that point. So I don't know, what did you guys listen to actually?
For me, it was like, oh, well, like the floodgates had burst wide open and I was like, I'll take kind of anything and everything I can get my hands on at this point. So I started kind of looking at some and listening to some more like kind of newer jazz stuff that's out there, like JD and Domi and Mono Neon, Wolfpack. I mean, kind of going along that line. And like you said, kind of rekindling some old loves, you know, like heavy dub, 70s dub, reggae, you know, some Lee Scratch Perry, some King Tubby, some of those early originators of the dub side of things. And then also, you know, my kids and I started kind of getting into TikTok a little bit more, and, you know, they have their own stuff that they love. So I said, hey, I got plenty of time on my hands. Let's listen to what you have. And they're into like all kinds of stuff. I don't even know the names of it, but you know, it's NCS music, I think is what they call it, but I'm not 100% in that realm. So, but yeah, it busted it wide open, and it was great. You know, as a musician, it's like, wow, I got time to revisit and really dig into some stuff here, which is cool.
Now, what about you, Cliff?
Yeah, I took it as a challenge, and it gave me extra time. So I gave myself the challenge of discovering one new artist a week, which
I like that.
wasn't that hard.
I like that there are metrics too.
Like my Spotify roundup last year, like I've kept it going, and I think I listened to like, I can't remember. It was like thousands of artists.
Wow.
And so yeah, it's just been, it was a blessing to me because I just diversified. But like Misha, I got in a lot of funk and jazz. So a lot of Snarky Puppy and
always lettuce. Listen to Snarky Puppy as much as possible.
Yes, exactly.
Speaking of Wolfpack, this Friday night at the Fillmore, Theo Kartzman of Wolfpack will be performing. We've got a pair of tickets to the lucky person who gives us a call at 415-648-7327. 415-648-7327, or hit us up on the social medias at KXSF Radio, wherever you social media. Somebody is standing by. That's for Theo Kartzman from Wolfpack playing at the Fillmore this week. Also, speaking of Domi and JD Beck, this week, very excitedly, did you guys see the Blue Note Jazz Festival lineup get released?
Yes.
How dope does that look?
The whole thing, all the way down to the tiniest of the names.
The entire page.
Days. It 100%.
Anything Glasper does, I'm usually on board for, like, completely. Sometimes I'm only, like, 99% of the way there. But for those of you at home who aren't familiar with Blue Note Jazz Festival, going into its second year, it is hosted by Robert Glasper with all of his friends, emceed by Dave Chappelle. This year we're bringing De La Soul, Bilal, Lala Hathaway, Mary J., Nas, Chance, No Worries, Harry Lennox, Rakim and Jazzy Jeff doing a collaboration, Tlaib and Madlib, Big Frida, Diggable Planets, BJ the Chicago Kid, Domi and JD Beck, Soul Live, Soul Rebels, Rhapsody, Terrace Martin, which if you don't know Terrace Martin, you need to get on that right away. Mono Neon, Ghost Note, Corey Henry, and a few others that we just don't have time to mention. Shout out to the folks up there at Blue Note Records for putting that together and having a next iteration. Maybe this year I'll actually use the ticket I have. So let's get back into a little bit more from Orbit 17 in studio. As a reminder, their debut LP comes out on Friday, April 28th, called Bonfires. You can go check out their Bandcamp to purchase. Support local artists as much as you can. If you would like to support them even further, and why aren't you going to go support them even further? You can see them a few times coming up this month, including Friday, April 14th, at Quarter Note Bar and Grill in Sunnyvale, which is just off Lawrence Expressway and a stone's throw from the very first place I lived in California many moons ago. Saturday, April 15th, you can find them at the Hub in Redwood City. And on Saturday, April 29th, the day after the release of Bonfires, you can catch them at the Caravan Lounge down there in San Jose. Any other shows coming up
besides that, on the horizon.
Oh, man.
Hub in Redwood City.
Yeah, we're at the hub in Redwood City. Did you get that?
I got everything that was on your website.
Okay.
So if that's all you got.
We got May. Did you get into May? The Bistro. Bistro.
And then July.
Vinny's in July.
Rock on. Rock on. Yeah. That'll be great. Yeah. All right. So what do you guys got for us next?
Next is going to be this song called Limousines and Laser Beams.
That's the lead track off of Bonfires,
that's right. Yeah, track number one. It's kind of a song about, like, getting back into real life again. There's a COVID, like, lockdown theme going on, you might detect, but this is kind of a song about getting back into the real world, essentially, after lockdown. So,
all right. Well, let's hear. This is Limousines and Laser Beams from Orbit 17, only on KXSF 102.5 FM San Francisco Community Radio. The joys of doing things live. I once had my power source go out in the middle of it. I was doing my top count. It was the only time it's ever happened. It was between songs, albums 2 and 1 of the entire year last year. And it just went out as Spud Infinity from Big Thief started. And I was like, oh, all right, well, we'll figure this out. And we eventually did.
Yeah. Okay, I think we're good to go now.
Rock on. Here we go. While they're figuring that out, I want to thank Babylon Burning for their support of KXSF Radio. Babylon Burning is San Francisco's oldest screen printer. Babylon Burning is a San Francisco legacy business offering full-service screen printing for your band and company, located in San Francisco's SoMa District at their brand-new location, 939 Howard. Babylon Burning has served the Bay Area since 1976. Learn more at their website, babylontee.com. Thank you for supporting KXSF and allowing us to bring in people like Orbit 17 who are ready to go with Limousines and Laser Beams.
Indeed we are. Let's go. Thank you.
And that was Orbit 17 with the lead track off their new album, Bonfires, Limousines, and Laser Beams. We're going to take a brief moment, thank the people who keep these lights on, and opportunities for you to support KXSF wherever you go. And we'll be back with Orbit 17 right after this.
Old Jerusalem is proud to underwrite KXSF 102.5 FM, a small family-owned Mediterranean restaurant with a beautiful heated outdoor patio. Old Jerusalem is 16 years in the heart of the Mission. Their West Bank cuisine is a traditional spread of Middle Eastern delights. You can check them out at www.oldjerusalem.co or visit at 2966 Mission Street at 26th. Two blocks from 24th Street BART in San Francisco.
Time to throw out all those ratty t-shirts you've been living in for the last 16 months. Snag some new swag at the KXSF online store in partnership with Bonfire. Score shirts in a variety of colors and designs, including those from some of your favorite KXSF shows and DJs. Rep the best independent community radio station in the Bay by going online now to kxsf.fm/merch and shop till you drop.
KXSF 102.5 FM is one of Community Thrift Store's charity partners. Next time you clean out your closet, bring your stuff to the Community Thrift Store at 623 Valencia Street in San Francisco and make San Francisco Community Radio the charity to benefit from it. All donations are tax deductible to the full extent of the law. That's San Francisco Community Thrift at Valencia and 17. And don't forget to make San Francisco Community Radio the beneficiary charity. Thanks for your support.
And thank you out there in Radio Land, wherever you might be, for keeping your Wednesday evening tuned to King of Prussia Radio, your weekly halftime new music report. I'm DJ BK with you every Wednesday from 8 to 10 p.m. playing the best music I found each week that's been released. We are in studio today with Orbit 17, playing those tracks from their EP last year, as well as their new LP that's coming out at the end of the month, because it is actually April now. It's officially April. That's Don't know when that happened, but it did. If you are listening at home and you want to know how you could get your band or your friend's band or whoever in the studio playing with us and sharing their music and their art with us, hit us up at KXSF Live at kxsf.fm. We are always looking to get people in here. Speaking of getting people in here to perform this Sunday in our usual live music slot, thanks again to Scott for the assist in making this happen when I just said, hey, I'm doing this. This Sunday from 3 to 4 p.m., Jules Leahy will be here performing for you. So get on board with that. And as I said, we are joined by Orbit 17 here. We got a couple more songs. I believe we're doing another two or three.
Yeah. A couple more in us, I think.
Yeah. All right. So what we got next?
I think Aurora. We'll do Aurora next, guys.
Sure.
So I guess this is a song kind of about, I lived in Seattle for 4 years. And when I moved away, I kind of just had this feeling of like, life is never going to be the same sort of thing, you know. Yeah. I'm leaving behind a bunch of friends, and I was, you know, happy there, and kind of always when I look back on life, it's one of the things that like, I always kind of wonder, what if I had stayed there? Like, how would things have turned out different, you know?
Well, you wouldn't be here with us right now, so you know, I think it was all worth it.
Yeah, this is clearly an upgrade.
and you know, we get less rain than Seattle usually, but
that's true. Oh, I would have a hard time going back to the weather, I'll tell you that.
Yeah, it's a lot, and you know, fortunately we are finally in a string of days that might even be a week now with no rain. Blessings to everybody. Sorry to all the skiers and snowboarders, you haven't had fresh powder in like 4 days. We all feel terrible for you, but let's get back into the dunes with Orbit 17. This is Aurora. That's Orbit 17 with their song Aurora. I absolutely love the combination of fuzz and surf rock with just like that. It's like a classical 90s is what I call that sound that's like under it. And it's a perfect melding. I really dug that.
Finally, someone put surf rock and fuzz together.
Yeah. Yeah. Somebody needs to. It's about time. My goodness. I mean, how else do you go down Big Sur if you don't have surf rock involved? And, you know, things are fuzzy when you're down there anyway. So, you know, we're keeping with it. Unfortunately, we don't get auroras this far south, but boy, would that be nice. If you guys want more information about Orbit 17, you can head to their website, orbit17music.com. You can also check out their Bandcamp page, orbit17.bandcamp.com. A reminder, they will be playing a bunch of shows coming up here in the next month as they promote their new album, Bonfires, which will be released on Friday, April 28th. You can catch them starting Friday, April 14th at Quarter Note Bar and Grill in Sunnyvale, just off the Lawrence Expressway. Saturday, April 15th, The Hub in Redwood City. Saturday, April 29th, the day after Bonfires is released, at the Caravan Lounge in San Jose. We are thrilled to have them here. It's been really great getting to know you guys. I'm glad we were able to make this work. The traffic coming up during rush hour from San Jose wasn't terrible. I was thinking about that and just going, oh no, it's a tough one. But everything worked out because it always seems to work out. We have got, I believe, two more tracks from you guys tonight.
Yeah.
Right on.
We've got two more. Okay.
How about we just pop right back into it and give you guys the stage?
Okay. I think, I guess we'll do Hummingbird next.
Thank you.
That was Hummingbird from Orbit 17, only on KXSF 102.5 FM, San Francisco Community Radio. This is DJ BK with you for another hour. Reminder, 10 o'clock, if the barn dance comes up, joining you for the weekly time of Hillbilly Appalachia, Twang and Twonk, and everything in between. It is the first week of the month, so they changed schedules. I think it's Rusty Spring, or is it Shelby? I don't know. I'm always surprised. I know. If you're familiar with my show, you know that I am sometimes right, and that's usually only about 5% of the time on who the Barn Dance person is. I promise to do better in the next year. We are coming up on the 9 o'clock hour. We've got more time for one more song from Orbit 17. What do you guys got for us?
Boy, time flies, doesn't it? I guess the next song we'll do is Recliner. It's again and kind of a song about getting up off the sofa and getting back to life. It's a little bit about my dad, you know, and some memories of him. It's probably a pretty personal song for me. It's one of the more personal ones on the album.
That's beautiful. We're excited to hear it.
Yeah. So I guess without further ado.
We'll be right back.
You are tuned to KXSF LP San Francisco. This is the King of Prussia Radio Show. I'm your host, DJ BK. That was Orbit 17 with their closing song for their set, Recliner. I really dig that. I finally have put together all the things I hear in there. You've definitely lived in Seattle. There's some Pearl Jam in there. There's some Small Sales. Do you know, has anybody here heard of Small Sales? They were a music film collective from Portland. They did one thing. Your post-electronic hums and hues and such is just, it made me think of them. They did one thing. Check it out. It's cool. They did like 8mm films behind them performing on stage that they filmed themselves. So we had that. We had Radiohead in there. We had some Pearl Jam. But mostly, you remind me of Brian Molko from Placebo. And that's a compliment. Yeah, no, that's all I kept hearing. And I'm just like, I know this one. And I finally got it. So thank you. That would have driven me crazy forever. We're going to take a brief moment here and thank the people who keep the lights on and other things going on at the station.
Support for KXSF is provided by Rainbow Grocery, a worker-owned cooperative that has been serving San Francisco vegetarian food and providing a model for sustainable living since 1975. Rainbow is located at 1745 Folsom Street. Visit them online at rainbow.coop. KXSF would like to thank Rainbow Grocery for its continued support.
Support for KXSF comes from SFBMR Real Estate, specializing in real estate services focused on San Francisco's affordable home ownership programs, including below market rate condos. Learn more by going to sfbmrrealestate.com or by visiting the KXSF website and clicking on their logo. Thanks for supporting KXSF San Francisco Community Radio.
Underwriting for KXSF comes from City Beer, a family-owned community gathering spot to sip a fresh draft while mingling with friends old and new. Visit our new home at 853 Valencia Street, where we offer a well-curated selection of beer, wine, and cider, both to enjoy on-site or take home. There's plenty of seating and an outdoor parklet, all in the heart of the mission. So visit City Beer, a San Francisco fixture since 2006, now located at 853 Valencia Street between 19th and 20th.
And we are back. We are entering the back half of King of Prussia for this week. We spent our first hour with the first band to play on this show. Thank you so much to Jamie, Cliff, and Misha for coming in. They are Orbit 17. Learn everything you can about them at orbit17music.com. Go to Bandcamp to get their music. Check out their first demo EP, Waves on Wires, released last year. We all think it was about October, November-ish.
That sounds right.
Ish. This is a new music show, so that's not new anymore. So we're moving on to Bonfires. Check it out. Go see them. One of my thoughts I had as I listened to you guys, and it's the things you can't really figure out or hear or put together, you know, just listening to the music or exchanging over emails. But you kept mentioning these ideas of looking back and thinking about, like, if life had gone differently or this. But there's one thing to do it through your art to reflect on things or to paint pictures of it in the hindsight, but it's also a testament to your, you know, writing and such and perspective on life of we're here now, this is what we're doing, we can take time to go there, but like we have a wholly unique sound that's ours. Like we've just figured out, no one's put fuzz and surf rock together. You guys did it. Congrats! And on this show, we fully believe that if there's a genre of music, it's because somebody does it well enough to call it.
There you go. I like that.
And so this show is also called King of Prussia. You may not have put it together yet, but if you sing King of Prussia, it's just like Under Pressure.
Yeah. I heard it right there.
And David Bowie was the ultimate, we are going forward. We are going forward. Whatever we've already done, we have done. And that really pissed off a lot of people along the way. You know, particularly Ronson, who he very unceremoniously was just like, bye. When he did it to Alomar was like, wait, I got through everything post-Ziggy until Let's Dance, and now I'm done?
And Bowie was like, yeah, I don't need you any. I'm moving on. It is David Bowie. Yeah. It is not Alomar's here, too.
No one's more.
And I just really appreciate that idea of we're going forward and the way that you combine the elements of grunge with the fuzz, with the post-electron, and all of those things take such familiarity and moves it forward. Oh, and I just want to say that that was really cool to see. And it's not something that comes through on, you know, streaming things because boy, does it flatten stuff. But that was really great. I'm so glad you guys were able to come. Anytime you want to come by my show, you are welcome to. Stick around and break down and listen to everything else I've got. Coming up on this back half of the show, we are going to try to get to everything we usually get to in 2 hours, which, since we weren't here last week, boy, is there a lot. Let's start out with some shows coming up. Let's do Thursday and Friday just to get started. Thursday shows in the city, and these are always, if I could go to every show.